IAM roles are a powerful tool for managing access to AWS resources, but they can be tricky to set up and use. Today, in this video, I will show you how Lambda function can use a role from another AWS account and make whatever you want on another AWS account. Pretty cool thing, yeah? Of course. In one account, you can create a Lambda function and assign a role as usual. This part is the usual work with the Lambda function. But you can, in completely different AWS account, create a new role and let the Lambda function use it. You can use this new role and do whatever you want. In this video, I will show you how to do it step by step. Normally, you create a Lambda function in one account and perform action in the same account. However, let's assume scenario that you have 40 AWS accounts and you need to collect information from all AWS accounts. You need to compare this information and then create some kind of report. You can create a Lambda function in one specific AWS account and connect to all AWS accounts. You can manage resources in other AWS accounts. You can read, write, delete, change. Well, the possibilities are huge. Okay, let's get back to our tutorial and create Lambda function and two IAM roles in two different AWS accounts. But first, quick intro. Okay, as I mentioned, we have two AWS accounts. Account A, on which I'm going to create a Lambda function and IAM role to control other IAM roles. And a second AWS account, account B. I want to control this account using the Lambda function from account A. In this account, I will later create a role that can be used by my Lambda function. Okay, but let's go back to the beginning, to account A, on which the Lambda function will be created, but later. Now, I will create a simple IAM role, Lambda01 role. Lambda, next. This role will only allow you to use a role, read role all account in each AWS account. I grant only the minimum permission to show that it works and to make it as simple as possible. You can allow your function to do much more, for example to save objects on S3. I showed how to do it in my previous video. If you are curious, you will find the link on the screen or under the video in the description. RN, AWS, IAM, one blank space and another blank space or white card. This allows you to use a role from any account, but only the role named read role all account. Review policy, add name, for example, assume role. Create policy. I will copy this name because I want to create a role with this exact name on account B. Okay, now we can switch to another AWS account, to account B. I will create a role that will have limited privileges. Now, I choose AWS account and I add account ID from account A. Account ID where I created the previous role, which means the ID of the account on which I want to create a Lambda function. Okay, only easy to describe. As you can see, here you set what you want and what you need. Next, add name, read role all account. On this role, you add a little change to the trust relationship. It's really very important not to use star and don't allow anyone to use this role. Specify exactly which role from which account can use this role. Otherwise, anyone which AWS account will be able to use this role and use all its privileges. I will say it again because it's very important. Specify which role from which account you trust and allow it to use this role. Here I give the ID of the account where the Lambda will be located and the name of the IAM role that I created earlier, Lambda01 role. In my case, this means I will allow Lambda01 role to use this role, this specific role. Easy, yeah? Of course. Okay, let's go back to the beginning, to account A. Now we can create the Lambda function. Add some name, Python 3.10, and very important. Now you need to choose your role, Lambda01 role. I don't want to use JSON. Yeah, import Bototree. That's better. Regions. On this list, I specify which regions I want to use. Only US East 1 and Europe Central 1. STS connection. I use Bototree client, STS. Account B. I want to use role from account B. I want assume this role. Now you need to specify RN. You can copy this value or you can write RN, AWS, IAM, blank space. Now your account ID and role name. Read role all account. You can add session name, for example, cross account Lambda. Okay, now I need AWS account access key, credentials, access key ID, AWS account secret key, again credentials, secret access key, and AWS account token, again credentials and session token. Okay, we can print some information, for example, read information from account B, from many regions. Okay, for region in regions, now I need, okay, now on account B, I want to use Bototree client. I need EC2, I need specify region. For AWS access key ID, I use my AWS account access key. For AWS secret access key, I use my AWS account secret key. And for AWS session token, I use my AWS account token. Okay, I want describe instance, so I use EC2 client describe instances. And for reservation in all reservations, of course, if reservation exists. So for instance in reservation instances, now I create a list and I add all image ID from my all EC2. I can print also instance ID, instance ID, AMI ID, as previous instance image ID, and region. And we can return all AMI IDs. Sleeper, add this. Okay, let's test. Okay, deploy and let's test the solution. Yeah, it works. So, as you can see, using a Lambda function in one AWS account, I read information about EC2 machines from another AWS account and from different regions. I was connected to one AWS account, but there is no problem to connect to several accounts. Just remember to create the appropriate IAM role and give it the appropriate permission on each AWS account. Subscribe to the channel and don't miss any tips and tutorials. Yeah, this is my blog. You will find there a lot of tips, tutorials, commands and scripts that will help you in the world of cloud. See you in the next video. Okay, let's get back to our tutorial and create two Lambda functions. Normally, you create a Lambda function in one account,